Today we're going to talk about register, okay? Okay, do you understand register?
No, I don't understand.
Okay, register is the level of formality of the situation you use the language. So, for example, we have spoken English or informal English. So this one changes from country to country, from city to city. It varies a lot. For example, here you have an example. I'm bored stiff in this lesson. Do you understand this?
Muy aburrido, ¿no?
No, es más coloquial. Me aburro como una ostra. ¿Vale? I'm bored stiff. ¿Vale? Entonces, todo esto es el lenguaje coloquial. El típico británico. ¿Vale? I'm bored stiff. For example, you badly need a haircut. So badly, ¿qué otra palabra? Significa literalmente malamente, pero no significa mal, significa como realmente. ¿Vale? So you badly need a haircut. ¿Por qué? Porque tiene aquí una greña, ¿no? You badly need a haircut. Another one. I have to think about it and let you know. So half a think. So this means I think about it. Yeah? I half a think. Another one. Give me a ring when you get home. Give me a ring, it's just call me, okay? En español diríamos, dame un telefonazo, ¿no? And there are more expressions like this. So you can say pretty, like pretty awful, pretty dreadful, pretty dull, yeah? So this also means like fairly, more or less. Yeah? Now, as you can see in spoken English, we have short words, very short words. Now let's talk about formal English. So in formal English, you usually have longer words or words that look like Spanish, for example. Passenger must not alight from the bus whilst it is in motion. Vale. Alight. This word, you won't say it in English. It's not something an English speaker would say. But it's something you might see on a notice. So, do you understand notice?
I don't understand a lie, no.
Okay. So, notice, let's just start with notice. Notice is one of these, okay? These are notices.
Cartel, ¿no? Mm.
Cartel. Okay, alight is get off.
Bajarse.
Bajarse. Pero de nuevo, una palabra muy formal. No lo vas a decir, lo vas a ver. Escrito. Muy raro que alguien dice alight from the bus. No, it's very weird. Another one. Cyclist must dismount here. Again. Dismount. This is get off a bike. This is a very formal word. You won't say. You simply say get off. Yeah. Another one. Trespasser will be prosecuted. Vale. Este está muy de moda ahora. Trespassers. Ocupa, no ocupa, trespasser. Another formal word. Oh, another one. Please dispose of unwanted items in the receptacle provided. Another formal expression. Dispose. People usually say throw away. Yeah. Unwanted items. Okay, items. It's another formal word we use in English, especially when you talk about shopping. So, item sería como artículo. And receptacle just means a bin. Yeah, a bin, like this. But again, this is formal English. Now, and then we also have the English of the newspaper. O rather, headlines. Do you know headlines?
Headlines, no.
Headlines. Okay.
Headlines.
This is a headline. Okay. El
Titular.
titular, exactly. Headlines. Let me take out the pen. So, in English, when you're reading a headline, they use special words or they use dramatic short words. So it's going to be different from spoken English. For example, you have axe or you have slash, slashes, yeah? Rocket or quiz, crackdown, yeah? Outbreak, yeah? Hits, yeah? So very short words and very dramatic. And in everyday English, they have a different meaning, but in headlines, they have a specific meaning. For example, computer factory to axe jobs. Okay, also notice the tenses change. So in headlines, when you talk about the future, you're going to use infinitive. So this computer factories to have axe jobs. This means computer factories are going to make people redundant or to fire people. Yeah. So axe literalmente significa hacha. Me show you. So this is an axe, but in headlines, axe is used to mean fire, to make people redundant. Yeah.
A despedir a la gente,
Exactly.
¿no?
Another one. Airline slashes prices. Okay, why we say slashes? So again, slash means like a hit. So slash is like to hit someone, yeah? With a slash, yeah? But here it means to cut prices, to reduce prices drastically, yeah? Another example. Government spending will rocket this year. Okay, what is a rocket? This is a rocket. So rocket, yeah? Cohete, yeah? Rocket. But again, here it has a different meaning. Rocket means to go up very quickly. Yeah? Government spending will rocket this year. It's verdad. So spending, gasto, see? Will rocket, will go up very quickly this year. Do you understand?
No, el gobierno gastó
No, el gasto del gobierno.
el gasto del
O
gobierno.
will rocket. Like
Ah,
this. Like
disparó
this.
o algo así.
Se disparará. Estamos hablando en futuro, ¿no?
Sí.
This is true. Police crackdown on speeding. Okay. Okay, crackdown is another expression we use in English. Crackdown means to attack or to be strict. Yeah. Perseguir o ser severo, yeah. So police crackdown on speeding. Speeding, you know?
Velocidad, ¿no?
Yes, but when
Pero
we talk about speeding, so to speed is also a verb. It means to go fast. Yeah? So you speed. ¿Vale? En español decimos correr con el coche. In English, you say to speed. Okay? So this is also a verb. Here we talk about going fast. Yeah? With your car. So police crack down on speeding. Another one. Police quiz 16-year-old in murder inquiry. Okay. So quiz means to ask question. An inquiry means investigation. So you can see we use short words. Yeah. And sometimes they are not very clear because they want the reader to read the article. So maybe the headline is like ambiguous. Yeah. Another one. Madre mía, esta parece una premonición. Flu outbreak hits Southern Europe. Okay, what is outbreak? Do you know?
Salir fuera o romper, fue.
Okay, wait a moment. We talk about flu. Do you know flu?
No,
No?
no.
Let me show you. So this is a kind of virus.
Ah, virus.
Which, yeah, but what kind of virus? It's a specific virus. ¿Cómo llamamos este virus? Gripe, yeah? Flu.
Gripe.
So, outbreak, when we talk about a virus, it means like brote, yeah? So, flu outbreak hits, so hits, or golpea, golpea, Southern Europe, Europa del Sur. Yeah? And this word, outbreak, we use it for two different things in English. A virus or war. Yeah? Pues un virus, pues a guerra. Okay, now let's talk about business English. So in business English, you have a specific kind of vocabulary. For example, you say, submit a tender. So, submit a tender is to present a document where you offer a job or you state the price of a job. Me show you. Submit a tender. Let me show you. Wait a moment. What's this one? Okay, let me show you the meaning in Spanish. Not this one. Oferta, yeah, this is oferta. As simple as that. Tender means oferta here. So submit a tender, yeah? Raise capital. So capital is a word for money, okay? To go into partnership. This one says that thing. And start up a business. So you could also say set up a business, start up a business, yeah? Okay, I'm gonna practice this a little bit. Okay, so here we have a few sentences. So you're gonna tell me if they are formal or informal English. For example, let me zoom in. So number one, can you read it?
Forma. Ah,
Yes, it's formal indeed.
cyclist should dismount before crossing the footbridge.
Footbridge.
Footbridge. Footbridge.
Let me show you footbridge. So this is a footbridge. Yeah, footbridge. Yeah. Okay, number two.
Never dispose of batteries and similar
Items, items.
items by throwing them onto a fire. Formal.
Very, very formal. Okay, here we have another word which is formal. Onto is the same as on, but with a movement. Yeah. Number three.
The students were all bored, stiff by le the lecture.
Lecture, lecture.
Lecture, lecture. Informal.
Informal. Four.
Passengers must alight from the bus through the rear door. Formal.
Formal. Five.
The grass badly needs cutting. Cutting o
Cutting,
cutting?
cutting.
Cutting. Informal.
Number six.
Please place all your tickets in the
Receptacle.
receptacle. Provide as you leave the building.
Building and provided.
Provide it as you leave the building. I don't know.
Very, very, very formal. Why? Because you have this one, yeah? You have this one here, very formal. Provided, you understand provided?
Provide era
Proveer o dar, ¿cómo dar? Provide, yeah? Provided in the past. Yeah? Disponibilizado, yeah? Okay. Not too difficult, I hope. Okay. Analytic and use meaning location. All right. So let's start with the first one. Can you read this, the whole thing?
Yes. Oil companies slash price.
Prices.
Prices. There was good news for motorists today as pump prices were lowered by the major oil companies.
Okay, so what is the expression typical from the news here?
Typical expression.
Slash, slash. What does it mean? You remember?
Reduce precios, ¿no?
Exactly, it means to lower or to reduce drastically, okay? Okay, number two here. Can I read it?
Let it is quiz
Quiz,
business ma quiz
quiz.
let it is quiz businessman over missing teenager. Senior detectives interview a man who has been named as prime
Suspect.
suspect in the case of a missing 18 years old who is feared to have been adult.
Abducted.
Adapted.
Okay, so what is the special word here?
Quiz.
Quiz. What does it mean?
Investigar era, ¿no? Otra vez.
To question, to ask questions.
Eso, hacer
And what is
preguntas.
the topic? Missing teenager. Okay, so detectives are asking this man question about
Sí.
this, yeah, about this teenager, okay?
Missing teenager es la desaparición de un ingeniero, ¿no?
Adolescente, teenager,
Tiene. ¿Y
que
cómo era? Ingeniero es ingeniero.
engineer, this is
Sí.
teenager, so
Ya.
that means the person is from 10 to 20. Okay, next one here.
Floods, High
Flats,
Central.
flats, flats.
Floods, High Central Region.
Hit, hit.
Heat. Floods, Heat Central Region.
Region, region.
Region. Towns and village in the central region were battling against Floods tonight as heavy rain continue.
Okay, badly, the battle, yeah, badly. Okay, so what is the special word here?
Height.
No, hit, not height, hit.
Hit.
Hit. Sería afecta, ¿no? Literalmente golpea, golpea. And do you understand flats?
Flash, no, ahí no.
Flats, ¿ok?
Inundaciones.
And be careful, pronunciation is a floods, not flood, okay? Floods. Okay.
Okay.
Next one here, four.
Four. Car film.
Firm, firm.
Firm. Two axe. Two hundred joules. The Prescott car firm. Firm, era.
Firm, yeah.
Firm. Has announced
Announced,
that
announced.
announced. That 200 workers will be made redundant at each Kenton factory. The job losses are the result of
Result,
fail
result.
results of failing profits.
Not failing, falling. Falling.
Falling.
So what is the special word here?
Axe.
So axe means to make redundant, to fire people, okay? And firm is company. You remember
Friend company, es verdad, yes.
that? Okay. Now this.
Entonces, Axe era
Ok, axe literalmente es hacha, pero aquí se usa como un...
recortar.
Sí, despedir, ¿vale? Vale. Antes te he pasado en tu correo una página con varios vocabularios típicos de aquí. Anyway, I'm reading. So I'm gonna read an English newspaper. Okay, actually this is a Spanish newspaper in English. Can I read this?
Yes. In London, people don't seem very concerned about the new coronavirus strain.
Okay, do you know strain?
Strain.
Ahora se
Extraño, no,
habla,
¿no?
no, ahora se habla muchísimo de esto. Cepa.
Cepa.
O variante, strain. Okay, can read this here.
Passenger on a flight from the British capital to Valencia said that while airport health control had been rampant
Ramp up.
Ramp up. Many Londoners are still failing to observe safety
Rules, rules.
rules on the strip.
Okay. Okay, we're gonna read just the first part. Just this part,
A day before Spain's ban on UK flights was due to go into effect, passengers were reporting
Heighten, heighten.
heightened health controls at airports, but a lack of respect for safety measures in London.
Okay, do you know ban? Ban, BAN.
Un día antes,
Ban, BAN. What is that? Ban.
pasajeros.
No, es prohibir. ¿Vale? Ban. What's going on here? Ban. Let me show you. For example, alcohol ban. Yeah, for example, yeah. Alcohol ban. Or Cada no. Flight. So this is another short word we use in English. It's very typical of the news. Okay. We're gonna do a little bit of phrasal verbs. Okay. Let's review vocabulary. More vocabulary. So we have give up. This is surrender. Do you understand this?
No, surrender
Rendirse,
era.
abandonar. So give up is a very, very common expression in English. You could also say, for example, give up smoking. Yeah, you give up smoking. You stop. Yeah. Okay, cut up. We've seen it before. So, for example, you can cut up a carrot. Yeah. So you cut it up. It means like this. Yeah. But it has another meaning. If you say cut someone up, you means dangerously drive in front. Let me show you. Let's see if I can see. No. Okay, so it's like this. So this person is cutting you up. Yeah, like this. So it's dangerously placing this car in front of you. You understand?
No.
Que te corta. Estás así, chum, te echa encima. ¿Vale? So you can also say, this guy is cutting me up. Yeah. Okay, do up. You remember this one? What can you do up? You can do up a jacket, for example. You do up a jacket, yeah? Or you button up, you zip up, yeah? You remember? You do up your shoes, for example. You do up your shoes, your shoelaces, yeah? Shoelaces. Yeah, you do up. Yeah, but it also means to redecorate a house or a room. So you can do up a house. Yeah, so this, for example, this guy is doing up this room. So that means painting, repairing, yeah, redecorate. Okay, wrap up. So wrap up a present, for example. So you wrap up a gift, you wrap up a present, yeah? But it has another meaning. Wrap something up also means to finish. So you can wrap up a meeting with numbers, for example, or with a joke. And of course, you can wrap yourself up in warm clothes. Yeah. Yeah, so you wrap up. Right? Like this. So they wrap up in warm clothes. Yeah, you understand?
Yes.
So wrap up means put on okay, put on. So you can put on the kettle, for example. Put on the So you're putting on the kettle, yeah? You're preparing this for some hot water. But it also means to increase or to add. Also, or sometimes also means to organize. Also used with clothing, can put on a jacket. Put on a jacket. You remember? And the opposite? Take off a jacket. You take, put it on, take it off. Okay. You also have go on. So go on has a few different meanings. We use this one a lot in English. So you go on talking, for example. You continue talking. Go on talking. But you could also say, what's going on? Yeah, what's happening? What's going on? Yeah, what's happening? But you could also say, go on at someone about something. This means you talk a lot about a topic. And there are many expressions like this in English. So you can also say waffle on, ramble on, bang on, rabbit on. For the time being, go on, okay? Now, breakdown. Breakdown has several meanings. Okay, usually we use it with a car. So my car has broken down, yeah? But you could also say to have a breakdown. So that means a person is like this, okay? So this person is having a breakdown, crying a lot, yeah? Very sad emotionally. So you're having a breakdown, yeah?
Ah, como romper a llorar.
When a person is emotionally overwhelmed, yeah? So it means like the person has a emotional crisis, yeah? And of course, a marriage or a relationship can break down. So breakdown is means like it's not working properly, yeah? And of course, you can also break something down. For example, you can break down a sentence. So that means, like this, for example, it means you take the pieces and you analyze every piece. It means to make it smaller and simpler, yeah? For example, we break down sentences, yeah? And of course, you can break down a door or a wall, yeah? It means to break it, yeah, to destroy. So you can go in, yeah? Okay, let's take a look at some examples. I'd like to wrap up the meeting with an analysis of the following data. Yeah, ¿ya está?
Me gustaría break up,
wrap up,
concretar una reunión con un analista para
finish,
finalizar con un análisis de seguimiento de los datos.
Okay. Having wrapped up all the presents, we put up the decoration. Yeah?
Tengo que estoy envolviendo.
No, abriendo.
Abriendo o envolviendo.
Habiendo envuelto. ¿Carrión?
Habiendo envuelto todos los regalos, nosotros pusimos las decoraciones o los lazos.
Okay, we use put up for Christmas lights, for example, a poster, a clock, yeah? Okay, next one.
To stroll around the wood once winter morning, I wrap myself up in my warmest clothes.
Okay, stroll around.
Stroll, What does mi stroll mean? Stroll around.
So stroll around, it's like this. You go walking without any direction. You stroll around. Yeah?
Dar una vuelta o algo así.
Dar una vuelta. Exactly. So to stroll around the woods one winter morning, I wrap myself up in the warmest clothes. Yeah? So wrap yourself up so you're not cold. Okay, let's try a few of this. So, just a second. I'm gonna close the door. All right. So, number one says, when I found out,
Find out, dejar,
averiguar.
averiguar.
So, if this is the past, cuando averigüé.
Cuando yo averigüé. Put on way.
Exactly. That I have put on another 10 kilograms, I decided it was high time. Okay, this is an expression. It was high time. Ya era hora. Yeah. It was high time. I started working.
I started working, working out.
Perfect. I'm cutting.
Put.
No.
No. Cutting up. Do.
Down.
Cutting down.
Do you remember cut down?
Cut down. No. Cut down.
Reduce.
Ah, reducir.
And workout, do you know?
Workout, a trabajar, ¿no? No sé.
No, no, not working, working out. Be careful. Workout,
Ejercicio, ejercicio.
okay, una cosa es working y otra cosa es working out. They're different, okay?
Okay.
So you put on kilos, you put on clothes, okay? You put on weight, yeah? Okay. I signed up, esto se usa muchísimo. Sign up.
Contratar, ¿no?
Vale, hacer el registro, apuntarse. Por ejemplo, esto se usa mucho en las páginas Facebook, por ejemplo. Te sale sign ¿vale? Significa rellenar unos datos, ¿no? A registrarte.
Okay.
So, I sign up for 1 year subscription. Yeah, a 1 year subscription at my local sports center, hoping that I would burn off, burn, quemar, burn off, se usa normalmente para calorías, burn off lots of calories, or you could also say burn off fat, in the swimming pool, swimming pool, yeah. On the
Piscina.
badminton court and in the gym. During my first visit, I managed to pull a muscle. Pull a muscle?
Pula maso, señor.
So to pull a muscle. So it means it doesn't work. Tener un tirón, yeah? You pull a muscle. While working out, no doubt, sin duda, no doubt, because I hadn't warm.
One up,
Exactly. ¿Qué es warm up? You know warm up?
ponerse ropa, no encima o
No, 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 no. Eso es wrap up. Okay, warm up. Okay, this is what you do before working out.
estirar,
Calentar, ¿vale?
Calentar.
Hacer calentamiento. So you warm up before working out. Okay, before getting on the machines. Okay. After my second visit, which was to the swimming pool, I came home and began throwing up. Do you know this? No?
No, no, sí, no hemos visto, no, ah, vomitar eso,
Throwing I put the symptom down, so put down, achacar, ¿vale? I put the symptom down to a nasty stomach infection that I must have picked.
pick up, ¿no?
Exactly. Pick up es como pillar, recoger. I must have picked up while swimming. On the third visit, which was to the badminton court with my best friend, I was informed that I would have to pay extra for the badminton court. The subscription fees were incredibly expensive, so I was taken aback. Taken aback?
No, I don't.
Let me show you. Taken aback. So taken aback is like this. You're surprised. Yeah? To be surprised. I was taken aback. So I was taken aback to learn that I will have to fork out. Fork out. Fork out, yeah? You have to pay a lot of money. En español diríamos acoquinar. So fork out
Pagar.
means exactly. Yeah, it means to pay, but it means you pay for something you don't want pay. Usually a fine, something like that. So you fork out. So I will have to fork out even more money. In the end, I gave.
Gape up.
Trying to lose weight at the sports center and splash out. Okay, so splash out. It has a
Decir,
different
¿no?
meaning. Okay. It's also related to money. So splash out. On clothing, for example. So it means you spend a lot of money on something you enjoy. Okay? Let me show you here some phrases related to shopping. So, for example, splash out to spend money freely. So it means you spend a lot of things on something you really like. Okay, for example, you splash out on an iPhone. Okay, notice the difference with fork out. Fork out is always negative, splash out is always positive. They all be means the same. It means to spend a lot of money, but splash out is positive, fork out negative. You also have queue up. So usually you queue up at the checkout. It means to queue, yeah? You queue up. Okay, take off, you know, put on, you know. You always pay for something, yeah? And sell out is like you sell a lot, yeah? A supplier has something.
Queue up
And
ese, o sea, es esperar
hacer
la
la cola,
fila.
yeah? Queue up. And pop into is to go to a place briefly. For example, you pop into the supermarket. For example, if you need some milk, you just can pop into Mercadona, yeah? You get some milk. So it means to go there briefly, yeah, for a short period of time. All right. We're gonna read this one more time. From the very beginning. Can I start reading?
Yes. When I found out that I had put on another 10 kilograms, I decided was high time I started working out and cutting down on sweet food. I signed up for a 1 year subscription at my local sports center, hoping that I would burn of lots of calories in the swimming pool or on the badminton court and in the gym. During my first visit, I managed to pull on muscle while working up, not up, because I haven't warmed up before getting on the machines. After my second visit, which was the swimming pool, I came home and began throwing up. I put the symptoms down to a nasty stomach infection that I must have picked up
Picked up.
while swimming. And on the third visit, we was to the badminton court with my best friends. I was informed that I would had to pay extra for the badminton card, the subscription fee,
Badminton court.
court. The subscription fees were incredibly expensive, so I was taking aback to learn that I would have to fork out even more money. In the end,
I gave up.
I gave up trying to lose weight at the sports center and
Splashed out.
splash out on a new bike.
Good job. Okay, let's try this. Number one.
He stopped it.
He stopped. Not stopping. Stopped.
He stopped work out
Working out.
working now or at the gym and since then
Since. Since.
he has put on about 20 kilos. I'll be
No, I'll be dashing off. Do you understand
Dash
dash
enough.
off? Dash off.
Dash era de dash off. Dash
Okay,
is era.
this dash off. Means you go quickly. Yeah? You dash off. Yeah?
I don't understand how that's all.
Like this. Can you see this? So it
Well,
means you
but that's
go, no, you go to a place quickly. You dash off. Okay? You abandon, for example, like this. Yeah? For example, this guy is dashing off to work. Okay, it means you are in a hurry. So you leave.
abandonar corriendo.
Exactly. So I'll be dashing off as soon as the boss. Remember? Wrap up.
Wrap.
Wrap up. Yeah? You understand? Wrap up?
Wrap up, comenzar, ¿no?
Finish.
Finalizar eso. Finalizar.
So as soon as the boss wrap up the meeting.
Wrap up the meeting. I had to go to
Length.
Greenland, not to
No. Okay. Drop off.
drop off.
Let's see if we can find. Okay, so this is 1 minute, yeah? Just you drop the children off, yeah?
Spedirse.
No. So you go to school with your children, and you drop your children off at the school. Yeah, you drop them off. You remember? No? Okay. Pick someone up,
Recoge.
okay? So you pick someone up, and later you drop them off. Can you see here? So the
Recogerle.
father, no, it's the opposite. The father
Ah.
is dropping them off. Yeah,
Dejarles,
exactly. So this is 1 minute.
¿no?
Another meaning. Let's see if I can see a picture here. Okay, dropping off also means to fall asleep. Okay, so you drop off. Usually when you are working like this, okay? So she dropped off in the classroom, yeah? She dropped off. Right? Quedarse frito. Not this one. All right. So while he's going on about performance standards. Okay, let me read this one again. I'll be dashing off as soon as the boss wrap up the meeting. I have to go to great length not to drop off while he's going on about performance standards. Okay. To have to great length, or go to great length. That's an expression. That means tengo que hacer mucho esfuerzo. To go to great length. Ir a grande distancia, literalmente. Go to great length.
Hace mucho esfuerzo, significa.
Esforzarme mucho, ¿no? So, I'll translate this into. I'll be dashing off. Me voy a salir pirando, ¿no? Voy a salir corriendo en cuanto el jefe termine la reunión. Tengo que esforzarme mucho para no quedarme frito, no quedarme dormido, mientras él se enrolla sobre los estándares de la performance, ¿no? De la realización del trabajo. So going on also means to talk a lot, yeah? Number three.
One of my
Colleagues.
colleagues gave me a lift to work, but no.
Cut us up, yeah. Cut us up.
Cut us up on the way there, and we crash it
We
into his
crashed
car.
into
Crash
his car.
into his car. So I turn up late again.
Okay. This a lift. Give someone a lift. Do you know? Okay, like this. Can you give me a lift? Well, for example, here she's asking for a lift. Yeah.
Eso, autostop, ¿qué quiere decir?
No,
¿O?
no, 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 to stop, exactamente. Que la lleven. For example, here. Can you give me a lift? Or here. Need a lift? So that means to go for a ride. For example, to work, yeah? Be careful because lift also has another meaning. So this is also a lift, okay? But when you talk about transportation or transport, a lift means usually you're on foot and someone with a car, and this person gives you a lift, yeah? For example, one of my colleagues gave me a lift to work, but someone cut us up. Do you understand this?
Pero alguno
Pero alguien nos cortó.
cortó.
Sí, o sea, meterse delante nuestra, así, de repente, ¿vale? On the way there, de camino allí. And we crash into his car. We crash. You understand crash?
Mi crash, no. Rozarse o así, ¿no?
So crash like this, okay? We
Crash.
crash into his car, okay? So we crash into his car. So I turn up late again. Llegué, aparecí tarde otra vez, yeah? So turn up late, we say. Turn up late. Yeah? You turn up late. You're late, yeah?
Llegar tarde, ¿no?
What is this? Okay, you can't be late if you don't turn up. Okay, if you don't turn up, this has another expression in English. So imagine you have a meeting, okay? And you don't turn up. You don't go there. So you stand someone up. Okay? You stand someone up. That means that the person keeps waiting for you and you don't turn up, okay? So you stand this person up. You understand?
Esperar a alguien,
No,
¿no?
no, 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 no. You
O
stand someone up.
dejar plantado.
Exactly. Like this. So she was stood up. Okay? Yeah. Stand someone up. Like this. Yeah? Very, very common expression. Of course, you could also say stand up. So you stand up. Yeah, like this. Stand up. And also you have stand-up comedy. Like this. Stand-up comedy. Yeah, sería monólogo en español, ¿no? Stand-up comedy. Yeah. So you have
Vale.
stand-up and stand someone up. Stand someone up, you remember?
Dejar plantado a alguien.
You turn up late, sería.
Llegar tarde.
There you are. Okay, last one. Four.
We decided
Decided.
to turn up.
No, flat.
Nosotros decidimos nuestro flat era piso, ¿no? O algo así.
Do, yes.
No,
Do
no,
up.
no, no lo he dicho, ¿eh? ¿Me has
¿No?
oído tú? No. To do
Do up.
what?
Mm
We want to do, o, do what, reformar era, ¿no? Algo así. Recordar.
So, we decided to do up our flat during the autumn period. We want to do our bedroom out in a new color. So this is another expression. Do a bedroom out in a color. Es decorar una forma específica, ¿no? O pintarlo, ¿no? En este caso sería pintar. Perfect. Let's review this one more time. Learn English, lo dice en español. He stopped working out at the gym. And since then, he has put on about 20 kilos. ¿Qué significa eso?
Él dejó de hacer ejercicio en el gimnasio y desde entonces él ha cogido 20 kilos.
Sobre 20 kilos o alrededor de 20 kilos. Ese about es importante. I'll be dashing off as soon as the boss wrap up the meeting. I have to go to great length not to drop off while he's going on about the performance standards.
Saldré corriendo tan pronto como mi jefe. Como el jefe termine la reunión, yo tengo
Tengo que esforzarme
hacerme,
mucho.
sí, tengo que esforzarme mucho para no quedarme dormido mientras él está
Él se enrolla, ¿no? Pues él se enrolla.
él se enrolla en un estándar
Los estándares de trabajo, ¿no? Por ejemplo. Number three. One of my colleagues gave me a lift to work, but someone cut us up on the way there, and we crashed into his car, so I turned up late again.
Uno de mis compañeros me pidió llevarle al trabajo.
No, me llevó al trabajo.
Me llevó al trabajo, pero
¿Alguien?
alguien nos cortó en el camino, ¿no? A nosotros chocamos su coche y llegamos y yo llegué tarde de nuevo.
We decided to do up our flat during the autumn period. We want to do our bedroom out in a new color.
Nosotros decidimos redecorar nuestro piso durante el periodo de otoño. Nosotros queremos recolorar el baño, cambiar el baño con un nuevo color o algo así.
O pintar, ¿sí? Okay. Do you remember stand someone up? Stand someone up.
Dejar plantado a alguien.
Perfect. Okay, good job. Vale. Esto para el próximo día, te lo voy a avanzar. A ver. Okay. Espera un momento. No. Ok. Expression with do. Tenemos do up. Do up se usa para la ropa o para decorar, ¿no? Do over da una paliza. Especialmente cuando dice do someone over. Lo mismo que beat up, ¿vale? Do without apañarse. For example, you can do without a mobile. Yeah? Doing es liquidar a alguien. Do away with es abolir. So, abolir una ley. Yeah? Vale. Do someone down, put someone down, run someone down. Todo eso significa criticar. To be done for, estar condenado. Be done out in, es que algo está decorado de un cierto estilo, se lo acabamos de ver antes. Vale. Do over también significa hacer algo repetidamente. Vale, y do someone out of, o cheat someone out of, rip someone off, todo significa timar o engañar. No te preocupes que esto lo veremos otra vez. Y
Más.
vale, voy a leerte unas cuantas frases y ya terminamos. The flat was looking rough. Rough significa como sin vida. So we decided to do it up. Dolling herself up for the party, she wondered how her night would pan out. Esto como arreglarse para mujeres. Dolling
Ajá.
another one. I got all spruced up for my brother's wedding. I even put on a tuxedo. Otra expresión significa arreglarse, este para hombres, spruced up. Y ya tenemos más ejemplos. No te preocupes, esto lo veremos la semana que viene. ¿Ok?
Vale, okay.
Okay, good job.